Good evening. This is CTV News for Thursday, April 19th. I'm Byron Scott. Thank you for joining us. Well, school safety taking center stage in Annapolis today at a state summit on school safety. School officials, teachers, law enforcement, fire, EMS, and others spent the day talking about how to keep schools safe. Now, the meeting comes just days after Governor Larry Hogan signed the comprehensive school safety bill into law.
You know, we go through, I guess, variations mm-hmm. of these tragedies. But each time we need to pull back, self-reflect, what are we doing in each of our counties, working with local law enforcement, fire and rescue to make sure we're prepared in those counties. But what can we learn throughout the state, talking to our partners? How can we be better prepared? We know when evil knocks on the door, we'll not always know when that evil is occurring. But how we respond to that evil is so critical to make sure we keep our kids safe.
The event was held at the National Guard Armory in Annapolis. Well, an 8-year-old boy was packing more than lunch yesterday when he went to school. Police say the student was carrying a loaded gun in his book bag. It happened at Park Hall Elementary School in St. Mary's County. Officials say they learned about the weapon through another student who alerted them. The 8-year-old was arrested and charged as a juvenile with possession of a handgun. Still unclear, they say, how the student got that gun. Well, chanting big money out, fair elections now, protesters gathered at the Prince George's County Administration Building in support of campaign finance legislation. CB4, as it's called, would create a small donor public financing program for county council and county executive elections. Supporters say it would allow grassroots candidates to run a viable campaign.
So what that's going to do is create a small donor fund where the money that regular constituents give to their candidates will be multiplied by a matching fund. So what we're hoping is that by having a fund like this, we'll have candidates who will answer to residents and not to developers. The money from constituents will go a longer way, and candidates that respond to residents will be able to compete with candidates receiving money from wealthy donors.
And supporters are hoping for a vote on the measure before the June primary. Well, distracted driving is on the rise at an alarming rate, that according to AAA Mid-Atlantic. A report now saying that the number of drivers who reported using a cell phone behind the wheel has jumped to 30% since 2013. AAA's John Townsend says cell phones aren't the only distraction, he says, that occur behind the wheel of a car.
Distracted driving takes many forms. Most of us think it's only the use of a handheld cell phone, but you can even use a hands-free cell phone and still be distracted because it's a conversation. You can be eating behind the wheel. You can be reading a book behind the wheel. You can be doing anything behind the wheel except the one thing you should be doing, which is driving. Now, when you are using a cell phone, you're 4 times more likely to become involved in a crash. If you're texting while driving, you're 8 times more likely to become involved in a crash. So no matter how you look at it, it's very dangerous. Drivers recognize that, but guess what? They still do it.
According to a 2017 report, the Baltimore and Washington areas accounted for a high percentage of distracted driving crashes.